in the early days of computers, the only way you could tell your PC what to do was by typing commands with a keyboard. This worked as long as you remembered what keys to press.
Control J D.
Things got a lot easier for average computer users back in the 1980s with the introduction of the graphical user interface, or GUI. A GUI is a way for people to interact with computers using pictures on the screen. In Scratch, you can still do things the old school way with keyboard events. But if you want your own projects to be easy to understand, you need to learn about the GUI goodness of buttons. Buttons come in all shapes and sizes, and they don't all work the same way. Basic buttons work by triggering an event, or a bunch of events, when you click them. This big button activates Dr. Strange Dude's death ray. When clicked, it sends an invisible message called a broadcast to the death ray sprite, telling it to activate. My button works fine, but it doesn't feel quite right. A well-designed GUI will give you some feedback that makes it really obvious you just pushed a button. Let's add a nice satisfying chunk sound to make it more believable. You can create the illusion that your button is being pressed by making it shrink just a little when you activate it. And lastly, let's create a new costume that will make the button look like it's lit up when activated. We've added a bunch of little upgrades, but if you look at its function, this is still just a basic button. It has only one setting, on. To level up our GUI game, we're going to need a button that includes an off function as well as an on. This turns out to be a little more complicated than it looks. Every time I activate this switch, I need Scratch to find out what the current state of the light is. If the light is already on, I need to switch it off. And if it's off, I need to switch it on. To get this working, we need a new kind of block called the if-else block. If you've coded video games, you've probably used if statements, which check to see if a certain condition has been met. In this example, the if statement is checking to see if my sprite is being touched by my mouse cursor. If I'm touching the sprite, Scratch will run the code inside and change the brightness of the button. But if I'm not touching, then Scratch will completely ignore any commands you put inside. The if-else statement works a little differently. Instead of just ignoring you until it's activated, an if-else statement will always make a decision and do something. If I'm touching, then it will get brighter, but if I'm not touching, it will switch back to its original look. We've just created something called a rollover effect. It's a fun way to give the people using your software a hint that this is an object that they can interact with. Let's try an advanced button. Our artist, Miss Lynn, has set up this big red lever sprite with different costumes that make it appear like Dr. Strange Dude is pulling it to activate his evil scheme. Every time it's pressed, Scratch cycles through 5 costumes to pull the lever up or down. We need to keep track of what position the lever is in, so let's create a variable called lever, and when the green flag is clicked, we'll switch it to off. Now let's add an if-else statement and get it to check if the lever variable is off. If it is off, then we need to switch the value back to on. If it's not equal to off, that means it's on. And so we need to switch our variable back to off again. Now we have a switch that nicely toggles back and forth between on and off positions. And all we have to do is make something happen when we pull the lever to switch it on. I've already planned out an elaborate scene here where lightning flashes, Dr. Strange Dude laughs maniacally, and the monster comes to life. It's all triggered by this message command, which will activate when the switch is moved to the on position. I've created a second message command that communicates with a bunch of the other sprites, telling them to stop what they're doing and reset the laboratory. Let's put that in the off position and try out our evil experiment.
It's alive!
Oh, that's pretty scary. Let's try switching it off.
Aww.
Pathetic fools.
If you want to play in our mad scientist lab and see how we coded this digital story, visit our Scratch page at Atomec Studios. In the meantime, let's see what this button does.
I feel the liftoff. The clock has started.